Hello, good morning. So for today, tatry natin pag-aralan yung ano, yung options for an individual income earner na ang income niya ay purely from business or practice of profession. So yung purely self-employed. So bakit yun yung pag-aaralan natin? Kasi ito, share ko lang sa inyo yung rates na available, no, doon sa BIR website. Sige. So yung letter A kasi dun sa individual citizens and resident aliens, ganito nakalagay diyan. Okay? Share ko lang ha. Lagi ko na lang din dito sa Excel. So yung letter A, graduated income tax rates siya. Okay? So ito applicable to para sa mga compensation income earner or yung mixed. Okay? So meron graduated income tax rate. So, actually, kung employed ka, wala ka naman option eh kung gusto mo ba mag-graduated or mag-8%. So graduated ka lang talaga. And wala ka namang ano, itemized or OSD. So, skip na natin yan. Punta tayo doon sa purely business income earner kasi dito medyo marami yung options. So, ito yung i-explore natin today. Okay, for those who are earning purely business income, so purely self-employed and or professional, so gross sales or receipts and other non-operating income do not exceed the VAT threshold of 3M. So ito yung important eh, hindi sila mag-exceed ng 3M. The tax shall be at the taxpayer's option, 8% based on gross sales or receipts in excess of 250. Okay, kapag ganyan, wala nang graduated income tax rate and percentage. Or income tax based on the graduated income tax rate, na syempre meron kang percentage. Okay, and we also know na kapag ka graduated income tax rates, 'di ba, pwede kang itemized deductions or OSD. Now we will explore those three options, okay? So sige. So ang premise natin ganito po, no? Lagay natin purely business income. Zoom in lang po ulit ako ng konti. Okay na. Yung kanyang grosses or gross receipts do not exceed the 3 million threshold, no? So kung hindi siya nag-exceed ng 3 million threshold, reviewin lang natin yung rules. So ang option niya dito ganito. Option 1, sorry. Option 1 is yung 8% based on grosses or gross receipts in excess of 250. Option 2 natin would be yung graduated na OSD plus percentage tax. Sorry. And option 3 natin would be graduated itemized deductions plus percentage tax. Okay, so sa ngayon, ito muna yung options na i-explore natin. So tingnan natin, no. So, kapag magko-compute tayo dito ng ano, ng tax due natin, ang inputs natin ay actually tatlo. Yung gross sales or gross receipts. Okay, so kunyari lagay natin dito, no. Okay, gross sales or gross receipts, and then yung ating cost of sales or service. So, yan. Babawasin din yan. And then, we have the itemized deductions. Lagyan ko lang na note, no, na itong itemized deductions sa to, excluding pa yung percentage tax. Kasi yung percentage tax, pwede rin natin siya maklaim as a deduction. Okay? So, ito yung ating inputs. Now, punta tayo dun sa magiging outputs. Okay? So, ano yung outputs natin? Yung total tax that would be paid under option 1, option 2, and option 3. Now, let's try. Outputs. So, let's try. We have option 1. Under option 1, ano mangyayari? Di ba, 8% based on grosses or gross receipts in excess of 250. So, ang starting point natin would be yung grosses or gross receipts. Okay? Ayusin ko lang yung ano, formula. Okay, and then we have a threshold na 250. Any difference, okay, yan yung magiging tax base natin. Okay, and then ang rate natin would be 8%. Okay, so 250 times 8%, so that would be the income tax due. Sorry, income tax due. Magkano yung percentage tax due? Zero. Kasi under this option, diba, in lieu of the graduated plus percentage, ito na lang yung babayaran. So, ito na yung total tax niya. Under option 1. Okay, so wala pa number, sa maya natin i-try yung worksheet na to. Okay, so that's under option 1. Sige, i-copy ko lang to ha para kita natin siya. Okay, and then next we have option 2, yung graduated na OSD plus percentage tax. So paano tayo dito, no? So ang starting point niya ganun pa rin naman, yung grosses or gross receipts. Okay, and then grosses or gross receipts, and then hindi pwedeng mag-deduct ng cost of sales, 'di ba, kasi individual siya. For corporation kasi pwede, kasi ang basis ng OSD for corporation gross income. But for individuals, ang basis kasi grosses or gross receipts. So direkta na tayo, we have OSD. Okay, grosses or gross receipts times 40%. Okay, so ito yung mangyayari. So grosses or gross receipts less OSD, ito na yung net taxable income actually. And then magkano yung income tax due niya? Okay, sir, based sa graduated po. And actually meron akong pin-repair dito na formula na ginagamit ko kapag siya ay graduated. So okay. So don't worry, ibibigay ko naman yung worksheet na to sa inyo. So ang income tax due niya would be kapag graduated ay ganito. Okay? So try nga natin, kapag 250,000, okay, exam, kapag 300,000, okay, 10,000. So tama naman 'yan. Okay, so 'yan yung income tax due, but also don't forget meron din siyang percentage tax due. Okay, percentage tax due niya would be grosses or gross receipts times 1%. So magkano yung total tax niya? The income tax plus percentage tax. Okay? So ito. Sir, wala naman ako nakikitang number eh. O, kasi wala pa tayong pina-plug na amount ng grosses or gross receipts, cost of sales or cost of service, and itemized deductions. Later, try natin siya. Okay? And then option 3 would be yung graduated with itemized deductions plus percentage tax. Let's try. So kapag dito naman, 'di ba, ang starting point naman natin always would be yung grosses or gross receipts, ganun pa din. But this time, pwede nating i-deduct yung cost of sales or services. Okay? Which is how much is that? Yung nandito, no. Okay, so this is the gross profit. So that's gross profit, and then less natin yung itemized deductions. Okay. Nakalagay din dito 'yan. But take note, yung itemized deductions hindi pa kasama diyan yung percentage tax. So meaning ito lang talaga yung mga business expenditures, no, na hindi pa kasama yung percentage tax na babayaran din, of course. So lagay natin dito yung percentage tax. Okay, so grosses or gross receipts times 1%. Okay, pero if dun sa deductions mo na itemize, nandiyan na yung percentage tax, hindi mo na siyempre i-deduct dito kasi double deduct na siya. Okay, so we have net taxable income. Okay. So, ito yung net taxable income. So, how much is the income tax due under graduated? So, copy lang natin to. Okay, and then how much yung percentage tax? Nagamit na naman natin to. Okay, yan. And then we have the total tax. Typo. Total tax. Okay? So, yan actually yung ating tatlong options. Now, punta tayo dito sa taas para mas madali natin makita yung summary, no? So, we have option 1, option 2, and option 3. Okay, yung ito yung tax due. Total ha, total na siya. Kasi pinipili nga natin kung ano yung best option eh. So, ito yung kay option 1. And then, ito yung kay option 2. Okay, and then, ito yung kay option 3. Okay, now we want to find the best option dito among the three. So, best option. Okay, so, and then, the amount of tax due. Okay, so in order for us to find that, we need to use the mean function, which is the minimum, no? Yung pinakamaliit among the three. Okay? And then, identify natin siya using xlookup. Lookup natin to dito. Returning these values. Okay, so let's try, no? Let's try. Natapos natin yung, ano, yung worksheet. So let's try to explore based on inputs, no? Mag-provide tayo ng inputs. So, let's say for example, purely business income earner na ang income niya ay 500,000. Okay? Ay, sorry. I-ano natin ito na konti. Widen natin na konti. Okay? And then, meron siya cost of sales or service na, let's say, 200,000. And then, meron siyang itemized deductions amounting to 60,000. Okay? So, dito, considering these inputs, we can say that the best option is option 3, graduated with itemized deductions plus percentage tax. Okay? So, you can play around this worksheet actually kasi sometimes better yung option 1, yung naka 8%, lalo kung wala masyadong expenses, di ba? Wala masyadong deductions na makiklaim. Okay? Yung graduated OSD naman, sometimes mas favorable yan. Yung option 1, option 2 kapag wala masyadong ano kasi yun eh, expenses. Okay? So, you can play around this worksheet. You may edit this. I-upload ko naman to. This is actually dedicated para sa mga students ko sa MA3 Strategic Tax Management. But, anyone who watches this video, feel free to provide me with any comments, no? So, thank you so much. Have a good day.